1 over. So what do you get? 4. Oh. Is that what you read? What you should get? Ln, you cannot have 1 over or ln, you see? Ln is definitely going to be that. Your negative sign is only for the cosine x. So ln secant x. So that should be the answer. And you put back to the equation, what do you get? X squared, z squared. Complete that. So x squared, use another pen. That pen got no ink in it. So x squared z equals to half ln secant x plus c. Don't forget. There must be a plus c. Now z is actually what? Y power half. Put that in. When you try to complete the answer, make sure you also put back the substitution that you made. Because your answer should be the dependent variable in terms of independent variable. Y in terms of x. Right? So you can stop there because there is no initial condition or whatsoever. Right now? Okay, thank you. Now look at C. Look at C. What happened to C? You're supposed to use the method of undetermined coefficient to solve this equation. I'm not going to solve this. I'm just want to give you the idea. The y double dash minus 2y dash, of course, you can change that into homogeneous portion. You should get your auxiliary equation as r squared minus 2r equals to 0. And from there, you should be able to get your y homogeneous. Right? And your answer must be y in terms of x. Because x is the independent variable. Next, you look at the yk. The yk is exponent 3x plus 1. So you have to look into the yh, whether any terms is similar or not. Right now, then only you can write your yk correctly. Quick, complete that. So your m is 0, m equals to 2. So your yh should be what? Should be a plus b exponent 2x. Right now? A plus, because ya, m is 0. M 0 means exponent power 0 is 1. See, your m is 0. So of course you should get a plus b exponent 2x. Inside here shouldn't have any more m. Right? So once you can write your yh, be careful. What is your yh? Is that correct? Is that correct? Actually, your yh should be what? Your yh should be what? Your y homogeneous portion should be a e power 0x plus b e power 2x. Actually, it should be this. Right now. Then, due to the exponent power 0, your answer should be this. That's all. And then, if you look at the particular solution, exponent 3x has nothing to do with the exponent 2x. But be careful of the 1. Be careful of the 1. The one there is similar to our A, constant. So that means, when you choose the YK, be careful about this. It should be, you can write this as P exponent 3X, because exponent 3X has nothing to do with the 2X. But when it comes to 1, it should be linear. I can write this as a linear C plus DX times by X. C plus dx times by x. I can just write it because one there can be of linear. It can be linear. When it is linear, means it's a C plus dx. But C plus dx, the C is similar to the A. That's why you need another multiplying of the independent variable x. Be careful about this. So your y particular must be like this. Of course, later you will find out that d is 0. Don't worry. You will find out that d is 0. Now, I would like you to choose question. Because when you are in the exam hall, we have 6 questions. I told you before. First of all, you look at the question that you can do first. Of course, maybe the question 1 should be rather easy. You solve question 1 first. And then you move on to those questions that you are expert in. What I mean by expert in? Example, question number 5. Why I want to choose question number 5? Because this question will give you a lot of marks. You see how much is the mark here? Consider the periodic function. We are talking about Fourier series. Right now, this is 12 marks. Rather short, but 12 marks. Rather short, but 12 marks. So we need to get marks from this question. So when you go to the exam hall, you have the booklet. Right now, the booklet. Of course, number 1, you can answer in this booklet. When you come to question 5, because you do not know where it is, you can ask for loose sheet. They'll give you loose sheet. Straight away do on that loose sheet. And then you can staple it somewhere. Keep it. Then later you readjust back. Okay? Now try number 5. Look at number 5 now. We are talking about periodic function. We are talking about fx given to you in that range. What is the meaning of fx equals to x plus 2 pi? What is the meaning? What is the meaning of fx equals to x plus 2 pi? What is the meaning? The period is 2 pi. The period is 2 pi. That means that graph is going to repeat itself after 2 pi. So first of all, the work or the best thing to do is to plot this graph. So everybody plot this graph first. Plot this graph first. Plot this graph first. So plot this graph, what should you get? You're talking about negative pi to pi. Right? Y, x, pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, and so on. Negative pi, negative 2 pi, and so on. From negative pi to 0, it is 0. Right here is 0. So it is 0 right here. From 0 to pi is actually x. Definitely there must be a pi up here. It should be a straight line. So that is the original graph. That is the original graph given in the question. Now you try to move this thing in a periodic manner in such a way that it's going to repeat itself after 2 pi. Put the y-axis now at x equals to 2 pi. Repeat the graph. Try to repeat the graph. See what happened. Then only you can determine whether this function is even or odd and so ever. Right? So put that graph or the y-axis to 2 pi. Put this to 2 pi. Okay? Then try to copy and paste this graph. Try to copy and paste this graph. Definitely this graph is going to be copy and paste here. You should be able to get this. Right? See that? If you do the same thing and put it to negative 2 pi, okay, and then you copy and paste this thing, I'm sure you should get at negative 3 pi. Right here is 0. And then this is like a batik production, you see, where the pattern repeats itself after 2 pi. Now, once this picture is there, look at the picture. Is there any symmetry about the y-axis? No. Is there any symmetry about the origin? No. So if that is not the case, definitely it's not even, not odd. Betul? Bukan genap, bukan ganjil.